Star Wars 7x7, episode 2104. Palpatine told us once upon a time that the dark side was a pathway to abilities some might consider unnatural. And today we're going to talk about how those, combined with some technology that dates back all the way to the old Sith Wars, helped keep him alive for the Rise of Skywalker. Punch it. Hey Rebel Rouser, I'm Alan Voivod and this is Star Wars 7x7, your daily dose of Star Wars joy, and thank you so much for joining me for it. So we are continuing our conversation about the Rise of Skywalker Expanded Edition, that's the novelization, and in specific, the audiobook version narrated by Mark Thompson. Thank you again, by the way, to Penguin Random House Audio for sending me a copy to check out. And in this particular case, for today's episode, we're going to talk about a couple of things related to the scene where Kylo Ren first encounters Emperor Palpatine. Now, there is a particular reason why the novelization is actually very important to our understanding of Palpatine in The Rise of Skywalker, and that's because there are no other sources of information about him in there, for the most part. I mean, if you know of something, let me know. But here's what I can tell you that doesn't exist, that whole dog that didn't bark in the nighttime situation. The Rise of Skywalker Visual Dictionary doesn't have anything about Palpatine in it. The Galactic Guide doesn't have anything about Palpatine in it. I have yet to read The Art of the Rise of Skywalker, but I have looked at reviews online, and one of the chief comments about it, at least the chief negative comments about it. There are a lot of positives about it, but one of the chief negative comments is the fact that there is nothing about Palpatine in it and precious little about Exegol in it. So yeah, it's rather shocking that that's the case. And so, you know, what little we learn about Palpatine and his situation comes thankfully from the novelization. And one of the things that we learn has to do with the giant mechanical thing to which Palpatine is connected. Here is an excerpt from the audiobook narrated by Mark Thompson, where Kylo Ren is observing this thing and describes what it is.
I am the one who led you here, who has foreseen that your destiny.
The figure moved closer. He was unspeakably frail, his body dangling from an enormous mechanism that disappeared into the darkness above. Kylo had seen this before, while studying the Sith, and again while researching clues about Vader's Wayfinder. It was an omen harness, a mechanical spine once worn by the ancient Sith king. Without it, the Emperor could not survive. But the Force itself belied any perception of frailty, because a cloud of darkness and need swelled from the creature, along with power like Kylo had never before encountered. It was exhilarating.
Now, when I heard this and went to look up what an omen harness was, it put me in mind of Anthony Daniels and what he said about Chris Terrio, about him being steeped in Star Wars lore. This is certainly something that would indicate that, or at least provide evidence thereof. Here is from Wikipedia. King Omen's mechanical exoskeleton was a metal armature used by King Omen, ruler of the planet Onderon, and this is millennia before Saw Gerrera was active. The exoskeleton supported Omen's entire physical body, having developed the need for it after years of relentless studies into the dark side of the Force withered his bones and decayed his body. And as for Omen himself, he was a human male Sith sorcerer and also a direct descendant of the ancient Dark Lord of the Sith, Freedom Nad. So if you are steeped in legends and you remember the Freedom Nad uprising, like, I even heard of that. I may even have a comic somewhere. You know, this is Tom Veitch's stuff. He also did Dark Empire too. So, you know, that was a pretty significant comic thread as I recall. But anyway, so that's his history. It says, as a youth, Omen was instructed in Sith teachings by his father, the previous king of Onderon. He became king after his father's death, as well as a Sith apprentice of Freedom Nad, who I guess was a ghost at that time. We're talking like 4,000 years before the Battle of Yavin, so way, way back. And as far as where this plays into the whole living forever business, well, you know, aside from keeping Omen alive, Freedom Nat himself lived 4,400 BBY to, 4,300 roughly-ish. At least so everybody thought, but it was just his body that was gone, but he was still living in spirit somehow until 3997 BBY? I don't know. So, anyway, what you need to know is that this was apparently steeped in some very old Legends lore. And then there's some newer stuff at play here as well, which I will let Mark Thompson tell you about in another excerpt from the audiobook here.
He raised the tip of his lightsaber to the creature's face, which brought clarity to his features. The Emperor's eyes were filmed over with milky blindness, and vials punctured his neck. All the vials were empty of liquid, save one, which was nearly depleted. Kylo peered closer. He'd seen this apparatus before, too, when he'd studied the Clone Wars as a boy. The liquid flowing into the living nightmare before him was fighting a losing battle to sustain the Emperor's putrid flesh.
And that fluid to which Kylo refers, or at least the narrative refers, is regeneration fluid. So this is the kind of stuff that Palpatine is using to keep his clone body alive. And speaking of Palpatine, there's one other thing I wanted to flag for you, which had to do with Palpatine's broadcast to the galaxy. Now, obviously, we didn't hear that broadcast in The Rise of Skywalker. The novelization has it, and I was going to play you the audio for that from the novelization. But as it turns out, it's actually been broadcast before, and I want to give a shout out to Tim McMahon, who is a longtime friend and supporter of the podcast, and also had his own podcast on a couple of different occasions, actually. He also happens to be a patron of the show and got an update about what's coming in the podcast this week through one of the updates we do for Patreon members. And by the way, if you would like to become a supporter of the show, then patreon.com/SW7X7 is the place you want to go for that. But Tim let me know that there had been a broadcast in Fortnite, the immensely popular video game. And so I now have to go take my two children to task because they both play Fortnite and didn't tell me about this. But apparently there was an event in Fortnite where it turned out the broadcast was played, and it sounds like it was voiced by Ian McDiarmid himself. So here is that broadcast.
At last, the work of generations is complete. The great error is corrected. The day of victory is at hand. The day of revenge. The day of the Sith.
So there you have it. Ian McDiarmid as Emperor Palpatine, warning the galaxy of some very bad things to come. And thank you again to Tim McMahon for letting me know about that in time to share it with you here on the show. And thank you to all the patrons of Star Wars 7x7 for supporting me and delivering this daily dose of Star Wars joy to you. If you would like to join their ranks, please do consider checking out patreon.com/SW7X7. And that is going to do it for our look at the Rise of Skywalker Expanded Edition novelization today. Thank you so much for joining me for the show, as always, and may the curve be flattening for you, wherever in the world you may be.
This podcast is not endorsed or sponsored yet by Lucasfilm Limited, Disney, or 20th Century Fox. It is intended for entertainment and information purposes only. Star Wars, the Star Wars logo, all names and pictures of Star Wars characters, vehicles, and any other related Star Wars items are registered trademarks and or copyrights of Lucasfilm Limited or their respective trademark and copyright holders. May the Force be with them. All original content is copyright 2019 by Star Wars 7x7. We hope you love it.